This city has a special morning voice, speaks to me through an open window, masquerading as noise. 10 million people waking up. Somehow I'm the lucky guy who gets to make you up.
Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. Welcome to my channel. I'm very happy that you're here. Do you know that there are unique types of accommodations in Pennsylvania Dutch country that you cannot find anywhere else? Also, there are unique Amish restaurants you may want to go to when you are in the neighborhood. So, today I will show you some accommodations and restaurants you can find only in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Let's go. Allons-y. I've tried various styles of accommodations, including places with a kitchen in different cities and countries. You can see why I usually want a kitchen on my first day in Paris video. However, in Lancaster, I don't bother to find a place with a kitchen because I want to have Pennsylvania-style food at restaurants. Today, I will show you a few different options of rooms you can have in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, Dutch country. A farmhouse stay offers clean rooms and a home-like atmosphere that serves as a convenient base from which to explore Lancaster County. Often, each room has a private entrance and an ensuite bathroom. Most farmhouses are at out-of-the-way locations and feature spacious lawn and countryside and farm environment. Some places like Amish family farms often offer breakfast as well, but as I said, I prefer going to a restaurant in Lancaster to enjoy a hearty and filling PA Dutch breakfast. In a rural or agricultural setting, interiors of the farmhouse and its guest rooms are both comfortable and practical. The morning at the farmhouse is so peaceful. Really, you'd feel everything so refreshing and idyllic. The farmhouse where we stay is not an Amish farmhouse. An Amish farmhouse stay would have been a great experience too, but I like to have power and Wi-Fi in the room. Red Caboose Motel was established in 1970 when local businessman Don Dellinger made a bid for 19 cabooses being sold as scrap by the former Pennsylvania Railroad. Don won the auction and devised a plan to turn the cabooses into motel rooms. Today, the Red Caboose Motel has 38 cabooses, a mail car, and a baggage car, making it the largest privately owned collection of cabooses in the world. The cars are parked on an actual railroad track. Rather than one linear track, there are multiple shorter tracks to keep the motel layout more compact. The motel has double rooms, family rooms, and suites. We stay in a small double room which is half of a caboose, and you kind of feel that you are in a train because it's quite narrow, but it's part of fun. The room is equipped with a microwave and a mini fridge, but as I already mentioned, we go out to eat in Lancaster, so we don't use these amenities. The bed is comfortable. Nonetheless, it's a caboose. It has insulated walls, but it's not really soundproof from outside noises. Buggies pass from time to time. If you like the sound of clopping, you'll be happy. If you are a light sleeper, you might be amused by the frequency of buggies passing. Well, it's in the middle of the field, so there isn't much noise. But that is why you hear clops of horses striking the pavement quite clearly. The motel is in an area with other railroad attractions, including the Railroad Museum of Pennsylvania and the National Toy Train Museum. So it's very convenient if you like trains. Having been welded to tracks, the cars are immovable. It really is a one-of-a-kind place. The Cartoon Network Hotel is a resort-style hotel located in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. The hotel is managed by Palace Entertainment, who licenses the Cartoon Network name from Cartoon Network owner Warner Brothers. It's rather recent because the hotel opened only in January 2020. The hotel consists of 165 remodeled hotel rooms, a resort-style pool, kids' play area, coffee lounge, and a gift shop with the Cartoon Network-related merchandise. If you grew up with Cartoon Network's cartoons, or if your kids like Cartoon Network's cartoons, this is a great place. The theme is carried throughout the hotel very well, including the rooms and pools. The room has enough space and the walls are decorated with cartoons, and even the bed liner is cartoon themed. Another bonus of this hotel is that it is within a walking distance from Dutch Wonderland, one of the biggest attractions of Pennsylvania Dutch Country. And there is another type of accommodations you might be interested in, Fulton Steamboat Inn. And as you see the exterior of the hotel, it features a steamboat, and actually the hotel is named after Robert Fulton, the developer of the first successful steam-powered ship in 1807. The interior of the hotel, including guest rooms and the in-house restaurant, is decorated in nautical or Victorian style. The property is extended to a nicely designed pleasant garden, a walking trail circling around a pond where ducks and a lot of carp inhabit. You can learn quite a bit about carp on site if you want to. There are interesting reading panels around the pond. As you see, there are a few uncommon and quite special options of accommodations in Lancaster. There also are restaurants where each of them has a unique ambience. We go to these three restaurants each time we visit Lancaster. Bird in Hand is one of the most popular smorgasbord and buffet restaurants located in Bird in Hand, Lancaster, Pennsylvania. If you want to try Amish cooking and Dutch comfort food, you can go to Bird in Hand Family Restaurant and Smorgasbord in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. The restaurant offers dishes and classic recipes from Amish cooking. The restaurant is open for breakfast buffet, lunch buffet, and dinner buffet from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Tuesday to Saturday. The only thing is that it's so popular that there is a long waiting list unless you go there at an odd hour. Oh, one more thing. The restaurant closes at 7 p.m. for dinner. Actually, it seems the last admission is at 7 p.m., so you cannot go there for a late dinner. Katie's Kitchen is an Amish-owned and operated family restaurant. It serves a variety of menu for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, including many Pennsylvania Dutch favorites from Tuesday to Saturday. It's a lovely restaurant whose setting offers a cozy home feeling. It's not a huge restaurant, but just the right size. It's a deviation from all the smorgasbord and buffet restaurants in Lancaster. Their food is delicious and service is great. It opens from Tuesday to Friday, 7:30 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Saturday from 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. And I must introduce one more beloved Amish restaurant in Lancaster. It's Dienner's Country Restaurant. Their food might not be super top-notch, but considering the atmosphere, service, and price, overall it's great. It offers a nice small smorgasbord. It opens from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. from Monday to Thursday and on Saturday, and from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Friday. As you see, you got to have an early dinner in Lancaster if you want to eat at an Amish restaurant. Okay, that's all for today. I hope to see you again next week. If you have liked it, please do give this video a thumbs up. I would very much appreciate it. Please subscribe if you want to see more of my weekly videos. Thanks for watching.